Companies around the world have been dealing with COVID and its variants. That includes PepsiCo. Many of PepsiCo's employees are on the front lines, both in manufacturing facilities and stores. PepsiCo's Sales Safety Senior Director, Kelly Snow, says the company has built loyalty with its employees, including those with disabilities, and needed to make sure that it kept its talent during and after the pandemic.
There were many considerations around our employees with disabilities, and specifically those with high-risk health conditions. We wanted to make sure that, one, if they did not feel comfortable coming to work, that we provided them a level of protection with their employment so that when things did settle down and we had more answers, that we would be able to retain them as employees, as that's very important to us. So what we did was we had a high-risk leave. That was one of the first policies that we put into place as a company. If you had a high-risk condition or someone in your family had a high-risk condition, that you did not feel comfortable then coming into work, we were able to pay you 100% of your pay to either work from home or simply be on leave while we worked through being able to provide the right level of PPE, social distancing. We had to re-engineer some of our lines and our cafeterias, our break rooms, making sure that we could provide that level of distance that people would feel comfortable with, and the PPE that we knew would protect them from either becoming ill or taking that home to their families that were also in those high-risk conditions.
PepsiCo also researched COVID to make sure its response aligned with the most up-to-date information.
So we were working around the clock to make sure that we were up on the latest research, the CDC guidelines, the medical reviews that were giving us recommendations for how we could keep people safe. What kind of masks should people wear? If somebody has a hearing impairment, what is the best mask that we can offer for that person? So really working through all of our ADA processes with our legal function and reworking all of that, reworking with our human resources team in the field to ensure that they were asking for those accommodations when an employee came forward. Those things are important for the business because that allows us to build that critical component of loyalty and trust with all of our employees.
Additionally, PepsiCo has an extensive program that focuses on mental health and shares personal stories of executives and their real-life situations. PepsiCo also provided educational opportunities to its employees about COVID and the vaccine during the pandemic. This video is fully funded by the U.S. Department of Labor's Office of Disability Employment Policy.